It's likely to hit 108 degrees today in Phoenix, Arizona, and tomorrow, and the next day, and the day after that. This past Tuesday, Phoenix officially recorded a record-breaking 100 straight days of heat at or above 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And since the heat dome over the southwest has not budged, that record is likely to continue to go up. Today will be 104 of days of 100-degree weather, and more than half of those days have been higher than 110 degrees. Record-breaking heat in recent years has also caused a record number of heat-related injuries, illnesses, and deaths across the globe. The World Health Organization estimates that 500,000 people worldwide die from heat-related causes each year. Here in the United States, hospitals have seen in the country have seen dramatic increases in heat injuries like severe burns from sun-baked pavement and metal, heat-related delirium, and heat stroke. But you should know what happens to your body when it exposes itself to extreme heat. The human body has evolved to maintain a core temperature of about 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit or 37 degrees Celsius. Our bodies are built with complex, effective temperature regulation systems to try to help us handle variable weather. In extreme heat, those temperature regulation systems are hard at work. First, your body attempts thermoregulation by moving blood flow outward toward the surface of the skin. The heart rate quickens, blood vessels dilate to release heat, the skin becomes flush. Then your body begins to sweat. As sweat evaporates, it carries heat off the body in an attempt to cool it. But if it's really hot, especially if it's hot and humid, these thermoregulation systems that we've developed won't be enough. The heart will continue to beat fast, putting strain on cardiovascular systems. The skin will continue to sweat, depleting your body of water and essential electrolytes. Dehydration will set in. Excessive sweating will cause an imbalance of fluids and salts in the human system. Muscles will cramp, they'll feel weak. Your heart will keep working harder. The kidneys, which help filter waste and manage fluid in your body, become strained. As your body loses water, the volume of body in your water decreases. So does your blood pressure. The blood thickens as it loses moisture. The heart then has to work even harder to pump blood to the brain, because less blood to the brain means less oxygen to the brain, which causes lightheadedness, confusion, dizziness, even fainting. When unable to regulate, your body's core temperature rises rapidly. If your body's core temperature nears 104 degrees, it reaches the threshold for heat stroke. With that strain on the heart, on the brain, on the kidneys, and the liver, all that's happening now is that your risk of organ failure has increased. If your body hits a core temperature of 107 degrees, your body's proteins begin to break down. There is irreversible damage to cells and vital organs, and usually comes death. Extreme heat is even deadlier than hurricanes, tornadoes, and floods combined. Last year was the hottest year on record globally, and this summer broke last year's record. Just yesterday, the European Union's Copernicus Climate Change Service reported that summer 2024 was the hottest, most humid summer ever recorded on Earth. This summer, the Biden administration announced a heat plan, an initiative to help protect workers from excessive heat, as well as to fortify communities across the country to handle extreme heat as it becomes more common. Their plan includes cooling infrastructure as well as heat information systems to help prepare and protect people from the growing threat of extreme heat, all supported by the National Weather Service, the EPA, and NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Meanwhile, as Trump and some Republicans in Congress continue to deny the existence of human-caused climate change, the Project 2025 blueprint for the next conservative administration wants to gut the EPA. It wants to completely dismantle the Weather Service and NOAA. We'll be right back to talk about this some more.